weather outside is not that cold, and if you take my hand, I'll walk with you to Georgia.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Country with Celine. I am your host, Celine Chimarki, and on today's show, we have a very special guest. Now, she is an inaugural Opry Next Stage Artist of the Year. She has 75 million streams across her catalog and currently on her debut headline Heartland Tour, and she's country's hottest. Please welcome Hailey Whitters. The whiskey in your soda, the lime to your Corona, shotgun in your Tacoma, the Audrey to your Hank. She's got Hailey, how are you doing today?
I'm doing so good. Thanks for having me.
Anytime. So first things first, I saw this and I was just blown away by it because this is a huge accomplishment for any artist, any songwriter. You received a Grammy nomination for your song of the year for A Beautiful Noise. What was the feeling when you heard that your song that you wrote, co-wrote on, is going to get a Grammy nomination?
Well, I got the phone call and I was in a very public place and I could just tell by Brandi Clark's, the tone in her voice. I was like, she's either going to make me scream tears of joy or tears of sadness. And I actually told her, I said, Brandi, give me a minute. I'm in a very public place. I need to get out of here. And thankfully it was great news. And I did scream. It was completely shocking. I had no idea that that song could even, I didn't even know it was eligible. I don't even know if I knew it was eligible, you know? So to get the call that it was then going on to be nominated for Song of the Year was totally mind-blowing, a huge honor. I mean, that's a dream I've had since I was a little girl, so I can't believe it's actually gonna get to see the light of day.
That's amazing. Oh, I could not keep my composure either. Like, I would be freaking out anywhere. People would think something is totally wrong. Meanwhile, nothing is wrong. Nothing is wrong. So let's just talk a little bit more about you. So where did you grow up and how did music come into your life?
I grew up in a very small town in southeast Iowa. Shuiville, Iowa is the name of my town. And we have two bars and a church. It's a very small town. I think there's about 600 people there, most of which is probably my family. I come from a very big family. I'm one of six. My mom and dad are one of nine. My grandpa's one of 15. So there's always something going on. We're all still very close. We get together for holidays and all that kind of stuff. So, you know, I grew up, like, I guess I had a very normal childhood. I was involved in sports in school and spent a lot of time outside, riding four-wheelers, fishing, hunting, camping, things like that. And I moved to Nashville when I was 17. So, you know, this record, I'm very excited for people to get to hear. I get to take people back to the town that I grew up in. They can see just where and how I was raised, people that raised me.
I love the titles of your albums. They flow so perfectly together. And now it's funny that you said that, a big family. So that's like Italians. Italians are like huge families like that as well. I mean, my grandpa is one of 13. My grandma is one of 10. My mother's one of 5. So I completely get that. I mean, like, sometimes it's funny because there's so many second cousins and third cousins and you're just like, you don't even know who they are until like you meet them at a gala, right?
Yes, totally. I mean, I've been with my fiance for 10 years now and he comes home with me and I swear, like, he's still meeting new people. He's kind of given up on even trying to keep track.
Honestly, I completely get that. So this year is going to be a big year for you as well. So you're going to be releasing your third full-length album, which is called Raise. So I can tell you're very excited about that.
Yes, I am very excited. I just got back from Europe last night, and now it's release mode. So I'm just, you know, I'm just very excited. I'm kind of fighting myself to not just drop everything right now. I just, you know, photos from it, video content. I'm ready for people to hear it, to have it. So Friday's going to be a big day.
Yes, it's almost here. It's so crazy how this year is slowly flying by so fast. Like, I swear it was just New Year's like 2 days ago. And now we're in March. Pretty crazy. But that's going to be a really exciting year with the release of that. And then you get to perform that for like everybody from now on. Everybody's going to be able to hear it. And now you've collaborated with some notable artists, I should say. I mean, Trisha Yearwood. Okay, miss. Jordan Davis, Little Big Town. So who else is on this list that you would love to collab with?
Man, I mean, the Queen, Dolly Parton, would be amazing. I would love to get to do something with her. I would love to get to do something with Alan Jackson. I'm such an Alan Jackson fan. He was such a big influence on my music and me growing up. We have an American Aquarium collab on the new record, which is very exciting. I'm a big fan of them. I've gotten to know BJ very well. We've co-written a few things, and you know, I'm just very proud to have him on this record. I think he really took that song, Middle of America, just exactly where I was hoping it would go, but I couldn't get it there on my own, so I'm really grateful for him stepping in. I think he really made the song. I would say that's kind of all my country collabs. Do you want outside of country collabs?
Oh, you know what? Let's try it. Who outside of country? Would you ever test like the rap water? I don't know. I mean, but like, you never know nowadays.
I mean, I don't know if I can rap. Like, I am the most just country girl you'll meet. But I mean, shoot, if a rap artist wanted to have me on a song, I would love to do it. I really am a big Phoebe Bridgers fan in recent years. I've become, you know, just completely entranced by her records. I would love to do something with her. Billy Strings, I mean, he's bluegrass, you know, but I'm such a fan of him too right now. Gosh, who else would be? There's so many great artists, you know, it's hard to say. I mean, I'm just tickled pink anytime someone asks me to collaborate or someone is willing to jump on a record of mine. I've been very lucky to get to collaborate with a lot of heroes. So
I feel like a Dolly Parton one, that's like in the future for you. It's funny you say that, because when I was listening to your songs, I'm like, this voice would sound so good matched up with Dolly Parton.
Aw, you're the best. Thanks.
Oh, you're welcome. I'm just being completely honest with you. But it would go perfectly. And now just, you were talking about Nashville, and I was listening to your song 10-Year Town. So everyone knows Nashville is a 10-year town. But when you're there for a longer period of time, it's kind of disappointing sometimes that things haven't gone your way, or like little accomplishments, but not like the big accomplishment that you want. So what did you say to yourself in order to keep yourself going and not getting so sidetracked by some of the smaller disappointments, and what motivated you?
I think that, you know, I would go to the Opry sometimes, which, you know, that place was the place that made me fall in love with country music in the first place. Mm-hmm. And I remember being in one of those really low moments and just feeling kind of frustrated and sad. I didn't know if it was going to happen for me. And I bought a ticket to go to the Opry, because that's a place that kind of started it all for me. And I got a ticket and sat in the seat. And I remember seeing the lights come up, the curtain go up, and I just had this voice in my head that was like, you are going to be very disappointed in yourself if you give up now. You still want this. Hang on. Mm-hmm. Keep going. So, I mean, that instance was very significant. I think just continuing to focus on records and people and music that was inspiring me, tuning out a lot of the things that weren't inspiring me, tuning out a lot of the town, and really just focusing on, you know, the music I was making. Brandi Clark is a person I've always looked up to ever since I got here. And she was someone I remember who, you know, it was so surprising to me. She's undeniably great, you know, and it was so surprising to me to see the town, or the industry, I guess, you know, the labels in town sort of just kind of like, you know, they were just kind of hard on her, and that really shocked me. And so she was always a little bit of, you know, a lighthouse for me too, you know, someone to look to, someone that I could just say, you know, if she's still going, I'd keep going. She's great. Keep going. So I would say, you know, she was a really big motivator for me too, to keep going.
Well, at least you have that kind of support too behind you. I feel like when things get tough nowadays, a lot of people just give up. Just like that saying, when the going gets tough, keep going. But it's hard because of everything that's going around you. When somebody is at this level and you're still at this level, it's just, why can't that happen for me? And it's so hard because it gets so in your head. So I understand where you're coming from with that, because every single industry is like that. I mean, whether you want to be a doctor even, or a lawyer, or in media, or a singer, it can get in your head, and you just kind of block that out and find that motivation and just cling on to it and don't ever give up. And then eventually you'll get to where you want to be. It just takes time, right? You got to trust the process. But you're clearly on a route to where you want to be, I should say, Hailey. So you also toured with Luke Combs, with all so many accomplishments. It's pretty crazy. You toured with Luke Combs. How was that like, and what did you learn from being on tour with Luke Combs? Out of, like, you know what I mean? What was it? I have no words. What was that like?
I mean, it's crazy. Like, I've never played for bigger crowds in my entire career than playing with Luke Combs. It is absolutely insane how many people are just fans of his. He has so many fans. And I think that one of the biggest things that I've also learned through him in that, on the, kind of that same vein, is it's because he is so good to his fans. He treats his fans so well. I feel like anybody can feel like they're Luke Combs's friend or something. You know, if you saw Luke Combs in a bar, he'd have a beer with you. You know, he's just a very down to earth, cool guy. And, you know, he's had this massive success, but he still just has that kind of, you know, like that sort of aura about him, you know, is he's just still very down to earth. And I think that's why people love him, you know, because he is, he's a normal dude. And so I really learned that. I just think, like, he treats his fans so well, and it makes sense because that the fans are the reason any of us are here, you know? But yeah, I think he's such a cool guy, and, you know, I'm very grateful for the support that he's shown us and having us go out and open these shows for him. I mean, it's been very instrumental in my career, you know, to get to play for audiences of his size. And it's been very cool to see too. You know, I opened shows for him back in like 2015. I don't think he'd even moved to Nashville yet, but even then he was selling out the rooms that he was playing. So I remember thinking, like, this guy is going to be big.
Yeah, he's a true talent, and I swear all of his songs are A1 songs. There's not one song that I don't think anybody doesn't like. I'm going to see him in November, which, with you saying all of this, I'm very excited now to go and see him perform. That's going to be a hoot of a time, honestly. It's just, I couldn't even think of a better word to say. I guess a hoot of a time. And now, Hailey, before I let you go, so I always love asking artists this question because it makes them kind of think sometimes, but if you can't think of one, you can say a couple. So with the new album coming out called Raised, do you have a favorite song on this album? I feel like you're going to say all of them, but if you had to pick one or two, which songs would they be?
You know, okay, I do want to say all of them. I won't. I will say, though, that, like, it kind of goes in phases. Like, I noticed with my last album, it was like, I'm really into Tenure Town, or I'm really into Heartland right now. I'll say right now, I am so excited for people to hear Boys Back Home. We did a video for that, and it's coming out Friday, and I feel like, you know, it's about the boys that I grew up with, but in so many ways, it's through talking about them, I'm like talking about me too, you know, and the kind of girl that I am and the kind of girl that I grew up, you know, just being and, you know, learning from those boys. And so I'm just really excited for people to get to hear that, because I think it's going to give them a very good taste of, you know, who I am and how I grew up.
Well, I'm excited to hear that song now. I mean, you can always send it to me prior to Friday.
Yeah, girl, we got to get that to you. You got to have that.
I love it, Hailey. Honestly, this chat was something I'll always remember. Thank you so much for chatting with me. And I can't wait to see all that you accomplish in your future.
Because it
is very bright, very bright.
Oh, thank you so much. You're so sweet. I'm so excited for you to hear it, and thanks for chatting with me. I really loved it. Good questions.
Ah, thank you. I try to do my research.
They're really good.
Thank you. It ain't the bartender.